Before some people will start telling me that they can't hear me, so if you can hear me loud and clear and you're in this live video, do well to put a comment in the comment box below. Just type I hear. While we are at that, let me try and invite more people to join me in this. Obinna Adibe. Who are those live here with me? Okay. Vosbet, good to have you. Abdul Ghani, Olubadamilare, Vosbet K. Akuma, Azuma, my friend from Ghana. Emmanuel Onyeyere, hi, good to have you. Friday Okocha, good to have you. Christopher Ame, good to have you. Joshua N. Okaila, good to have you. Okay, I'm Matthew, one of your new members. It's good to have you, Joshua. Matthew, good to have you in our group. Christopher Ame, good to have you. Can we start now, please? Relax, Christopher. It's at my own pace, not at your own pace, my brother. Relax. I'm the moderator here, you're not. So please, calm down at my pace, okay? Don't be faster than your shadow. Meanwhile, if you can hear me loud and clear, kindly place a comment in the comment section below. So I know, just say I hear you. If you can hear me loud and clear, kindly place a comment here saying I hear you. Okay, so if you can hear me, kindly place a comment in the comment section below. While we are on that, let me actually send out more invites to more people to join us. And remember, there won't be any replay to this video. I intend to make more videos like this. Okay, thank you, Dazzling Queen. Thank you, you can hear me loud and clear. Welcome, Ned Adichie. I intend to do more videos like this. These are things you won't be taught anywhere else, apart from the Agric Money Network. So in subsequent videos, some will be recorded, some won't be recorded. Okay, thank you for placing a comment. Ned Adichie, you can hear me loud and clear. Thank you very much. That means I'm very audible. Okay, so let me send out some invitations to more people to join us before we continue. So I'll be right back. Yeah. Thank you very much, Azik Ibrahim. Thank you for joining me. Thank you, Mike Styles in the BC, for joining me. Christopher Amen. Okay, thank you for, yeah, you can hear me. Oh, sorry, I didn't mean, no problem. It's okay, I understand. I think we can proceed. Okay. Let's proceed while others can catch up with where we at. Whenever they join. Okay. All right, guys. All you need to start a profitable grass cutter farming business. There are things that you actually need to start a profitable grass cutter farming business. These are things that are very simple for you to actually overlook. But actually having them is what makes the difference between you and an amateur in this industry. The key word of this my training is actually profitable grass cutter farming. It is one thing to raise grass cutters. It is one thing to, it is another thing to profit from grass cutter farming. If you are going to profit from grass cutter farming, then you should have the mindset that this is actually a business. The moment you start seeing your grass cutter farming enterprise as a business, that is a tool that can actually aid you to become profitable in your grass cutter farming business. So in this particular training, I'm going to be showing you all you need, everything you need to start a profitable grass cutter farming business. There are three sectors that you actually need things in. The first sector is the breeding sector. The second sector is the marketing sector. And the third sector is the delivery sector. You actually have to breed these animals. You actually have to market these animals to make sales. And you actually have to deliver it to the place, to the buyer, to the location where the buyer who bought these grass cutter farming products from you actually the domicile. So for breeding, you need things. You need these 8 things as you can see I've listed in my slide, in this slide. You need the breeding knowledge, you need pen, you need cages, you need drinking troughs, you need a feed source, you need a first aid box, you need farm implements for your farm, and you need a farm hand. I would have added farm hands, but according to your capacity, you need a farm hand or farm hands. And if you're going into commercial, large scale commercial grass cutter farming, you need farm hands, not just a farm hand. So these are the 8 things you need in the breeding section. Then in the marketing section, you need a customer avatar, you need a traffic source, and you need marketing tools. Yes, you need marketing tools in your marketing section. Then for the delivery, you simply need a transport and logistics company. After all said and done, these products have to move from point A to point B. Point A being your own point, that is the farm or your store, to the buyer's location. And this involves transport and logistic companies. You can't do that alone. Take for instance, a buyer from Zaria or from Lagos or from Abuja purchases your grass cutters. You can't take the stress of moving from here to Abuja to go and supply those grass cutters, except on special locations. By special locations, I mean maybe you have a special arrangement with the buyer, or maybe the animals you are transporting are maybe a large quantity of animals, like say 5, 10, 20 colonies. Then actually, I suggest you move with these animals by yourself, depending on the arrangement you have with the buyer. But aside that, all you simply need is a transport and logistics company within your vicinity, plying that route, and you use them to deliver your products and services. Now let's take them one by one. Now for breeding knowledge, to acquire breeding knowledge, you need to get this knowledge in books. You can get it in videos, you can get it through one-on-one training, you can get it through group training, you can get it through webinars such as this one you are attending. You can develop breeding knowledge from books, from PDFs. You can go online, make God your friend. One of the things I understand is that people actually are too lazy to do research. If you actually dedicate a lot of time to doing research, you see that there are a lot of materials, irrespective of how not too sufficient the documentations on grass cutter farming is on the internet. there are still valuable material that you can discover online. If you go online, you're going to see a lot of PDFs, a lot of ebooks written by researchers and by grasshopper farmers. There are paid ones and there are free ones. Free ones are especially research papers that are published in journals. Simply call up your Google Chrome or Opera Mini or Opera or whatever browser you use. Go to Google and search grasshopper farming PDFs. You will see Google will provide you a wide range of results. All you simply need to do is to create a folder on your desktop or your desktop or laptop, whatever you are surfing with. Then download these files into this folder. I have over 50 PDF materials, all on grasshopper farming, grasshopper anatomy, grasshopper health management, grasshopper feeding, a lot of research documents on grasshopper that I downloaded simply by going to Google. When I started my grasshopper farming business, after my first training, virtually everything I learned by myself. Apart from attending seminars, I also took the time to sit down at times like this and download materials and go through them. Those materials I downloaded were what formed the core of my grasshopper farming knowledge. Before I started going to trainings, to Ogun State, to Lagos, to get more knowledge. So you can acquire breeding knowledge through books. You can also acquire them through videos. You can go to YouTube and Google grasshopper farming, and you will see a wide range of results Google, YouTube will provide for you in terms of grasshopper farming. A lot of videos on what grasshoppers eat, on grasshoppers giving birth, on the type of cages you need to house your grasshoppers. YouTube is a veritable resource that you can use to enrich yourself in terms of knowledge on grasshopper farming. So do not despise it. Go to YouTube and Google grasshopper farming and see a wide range of videos. Just binge watch virtually the whole video is there. For one-on-one training can only be gotten through you attending a live training at a chosen farmer's farm. A one-on-one training can also come through WhatsApp training, it can also come through Skype training, it can also come through a Facebook live training, where you go into a Facebook live interaction with whosoever it is that is taking you to the grasshopper farming knowledge which you seek to acquire, and they download the information you need to you through a live video just like this. Then for group training, you can simply join a group to get more information on grasshopper farming. You can simply join a live group or an online group where information on grasshopper farming is being shared. I think that there are a wide range of groups on Facebook right here that deal on grasshopper farming and micro livestock. Locate such groups, go there and simply pull knowledge for yourself. Equip yourself with this knowledge that are in these groups. You can also get this through webinars, like I've said. This webinar, for example, is one of the places where you get information about how to breed grasshoppers. Next is a pen. You need a pen. A pen is actually a shelter where you actually house your grasshoppers using cages. If you can see inside, this is a pen. This is a concrete wall cage. These are cages built inside this pen. These are bricklayers fine-tuning this pen. This is a 40-colony pen for 40 families of grasshoppers. So these are the cages. The pen is the enclosure. The pen is the shelter that houses the cages and the animals. So you need a pen for a profitable grasshopper farming business. You need a pen. Your pen can either house iron cages, or it can house concrete cages, concrete wall cages, or concrete floor cages. You also need cages. Cages, like I said, these are cages. This is called a concrete wall cage because they are made of concrete and they are made on the walls of the pen or the shelter, so to say. This is called a concrete floor cage. As you can see, the cages are made on the floor and they are made of concrete with lids on them and the walls of the pen. This is the pen. This is the cages. And these are iron cages, iron mesh cages, cages made with iron meshes. So these are the measurements for concrete wall cages. If you're looking at starting a grasshopper farming business on a large scale, I suggest you use concrete wall cages or concrete floor cages. But Concrete work or a work edge is mostly used for those who intend to go into large scale grass pasture farming production. So for the measurement you're going to use, you simply use the length for each cage. Each cage is made up of two rooms. That is room one and room two make up a cage of grass pasture. So the length for this is 5 feet. Then it is divided in between 5 feet, 2.5, 2.5. Then for the height is 14 inches. The depth, that is the depth inside, is 28 inches. For concrete floor cages, it's almost the same thing. The difference here is the width, which is 20 inches. The height is 28 inches. For measurements for iron mesh cages, also the same thing. The only difference is the height for each deck. Each deck, like you see these cages here are 4 decker cages. 1, 2, 3, 4. So for each of the decks, the height is 14 inches. Then for the space in between, this system of housing grass cutters is very beautiful. I learned it from a friend in Ghana. It is designed in such a way that when the grass cutters, the beddings of the cages are made of iron mesh steel. So when the grass cutters pass the droppings pass through those nets and fall into a collection pan, which is put in between deck one and deck two. So this space here is, it should be 8 inches. 8 inches and the pan, and there should be a collection pan here, so that once the grass cutters pass their droppings, it passes from that net to the pan. In the morning, you simply come and pack those droppings, bag them and sell. Some sell 350, some sell 250. I sell 300 naira for a bag of grass cutter dung. Next, what next do you need to start a profitable grass farming business? You need troughs. Troughs are what made giving grass cutters water so easy and simple. If you intend to make a trough, one of the advice I give to intending grass cutter farmers is this: before your animals arrive, ensure that you have troughs on ground, because one of the ways we get grass cutters to adapt when they come into our farms is that once they enter our farms, we simply give them sugar lemon solution inside the drinking trough. And remember, the moment they come into your farm, they are still aggressive. They are very aggressive, looking for ways to run away. That is, if you don't properly provide them with the techniques to douse their temper, they will simply start causing havoc inside the cage. So imagine where you are giving them water with a plastic container or a stainless container. They will simply throw away the solution. But with troughs, my brother, life is easy. All you simply need to do is just get the sugar lemon solution and put into the trough, one trough, and drop in the cage. When after trying to escape and they find out that there is no one, this is home, you simply relax and come and take the sugar solution. These troughs are made with cement, sand, and stone. Simply mold them, get a mold and mold them. As you can see here, these are the molds used to mold them. After molding them, you leave them for 2 to 7 days to dry. Then ensure you treat it with water and detergent. Ensure you treat it well to avoid the remnants of the cement causing challenges for your animals when they take in the water. The next thing you need to start a profitable grass cutter farming business is a source for your feed, a feed source. Basically, 70 to 80% of grass cutter food is forage, that is grasses. And these grasses we are talking about grow virtually everywhere around us. You can see them in primary schools, in secondary schools, by the roadside, even virtually everywhere around us you can see these grasses. These grasses include, but are not limited to, guinea grass, elephant grass, the one Abians call achara. I think they use it to make soup. This one in particular, elephant grass, that looks like sugarcane. Elephant grass, guinea grass. They eat spear grass, you know. Virtually every grass around you, grass cutter can consume them. All you simply need to do is there's a particular app called Plant Snap. Download Plant Snap and use it to snap pictures. You need to get the name of forage around you. Well, how it simply works is this: you simply download the app, you see a plant, you snap the plant, the app will run the the image you snap to its director and give you the name of that particular grass or plant. It's very awesome. So you need to download that app and use it to identify feed that grasshoppers eat, forage that grasshoppers eat. Then also you need market women. Market women are people that will deliver things like ugu stem, pineapple crown, corn husk, watermelon, you know, where are they? Cucumber. These are foods that grasshoppers eat. And market women, these women, they sell these things, and at the end of the day, they dispose these things as waste. Imagine a market woman who sells ugu. What she simply does is she picks the leaves. After picking the leaves, she sells it to consumers. And then she loads the ugu stems and throws away because it is waste. Nobody eats ugu stems. But my brother in the Lord, grasshoppers consume ugu stem. So all you simply need to do is in the morning when you're leaving, the moment you're passing through that popular market, like when I was at Omoto, every morning before I go to building materials, because my father used to have an office, my father has an office at building materials where he sells roofing nails. I will take empty rice sack, two, drop with one ugu woman. All she does is, after selling her ugu for the day, she loads the stems inside the branch. When I come back from the market, I pick and I come and feed my grasshopper with it in the evening. So locate market women around you who are indeed selling these items. Get them to give you the remnants when they are done and use it to feed your grasshoppers free of charge. You know, if you are intending to start a profitable grasshopper farming business, my brother, you need to locate these women. They will make life easy for you. Then the next people you need to locate is sugarcane sellers. Oh, my testimony about sugarcane is awesome. Before, I used to be at the mercy of sugarcane sellers, abokis that sell sugarcane in wheelbarrows. So it used to be that whenever I feed my grasshopper with sugarcane, it's only when I'm able to lay my eyes on those guys. But fortunately for me, a friend of mine came and introduced me to a park where northerners come and offload their sugarcane. My brother, if you see the heaps that they leave behind after taking the good ones that they intend to sell to us, the consumers. Hey! All I simply did, I just drive to that place and load my boots, so get somebody. Because around there, there's also some a poultry market. So those guys that kill, when you buy chicken, they help you to kill the, when you buy a bird, they help you to kill the bird, behead the bird, and they take out the feathers, they feather the bird, then cut it for, chop it up for you. Those guys, I pay them, give them tips, 200, 400 at times. They simply load those sugarcane remnants into my boots. So you see, simply by me identifying this particular part, sugarcane is like a normal delicacy to my grasshoppers. I feed them sugarcane whenever I intend to, not whenever I now see sugarcane sellers. So you need to identify feed sources for your grasshoppers. If you don't identify feed sources for your grasshoppers, it's going to be very challenging. Ensure that these sources of feed are around you, because these make your grasshopper farming venture easy to manage. If you don't have these sources of feed around, let me tell you what will happen to you. You will adopt a system of buying agro-buy products in the market. You adopt a system of buying apple cassava tubers. You adopt a system of buying corn to feed your grasshoppers. But the idea of grasshopper farming is that you put in virtually little money to reap out much. And they said that they are feeding 70 to 80%, if not 90%, is forage. So you see, to start and run a profitable grasshopper farming business, identifying feed sources is very, very vital. Next is its first aid box. If you do not have a first aid box in your grasshopper farm, you are simply piling up money for a vet. Here is what I mean. Take for instance, you mistakenly pair male grasshoppers who are sexually matured. Remember that grasshoppers are not supposed, male grasshoppers that are sexually matured are supposed to stay together. But if you mistakenly pair one or more of them and they start fighting and you're not around, my brother, my sister, you are going to have challenges because that fight will lead to death. And maybe you will return in time to see that one has been badly injured. and don't have a first aid box to simply take spirits, grab the animal, clean the wounded area to clean it up to avoid infection, and maybe apply gentle violet. You simply have to start running to go and get GV or dental violet. By then, it might be too late and infection might have entered. Or you might say, you might decide to call a vet, and that one will come and chop your money to just simply clean and use a GV to take care of grasshoppers. Grasshoppers are hardy animals. You should have a first aid box. You should have a first aid box. Losing a grasshopper is a challenge. Imagine losing an animal at 15,000 naira. Check it out now, between 79,000 divided by 5, let's say 16,000 naira. So imagine losing one animal, one or two, when you can actually do something about it. Your first aid box should include things like GV, cotton wool, antibiotics, chloramphenicol or oxytetracycline, scissors, razor blade. Your first aid box should include these vital things. The moment you have these vital things in your first aid box, is actually you're actually setting up yourself for success. Take for instance, you come into your farm and you find out that there has been a bacterial infection. You need antibiotics immediately to be able to neutralize or arrest the situation. And imagine your first aid box, you don't have that. A profitable grafted farmer has a first aid box, and so should you. Farm implements. If you are successful, if you want to have a profitable grasshopper farm, you need these farm implements. You need machetes for cutting your grasses. You need machetes for cutting any maybe your sugarcane or anything you need to cut. You need wheelbarrow to be able to carry things in your farm. You need shovel. You need transport boxes. They are very, very important. Transport boxes are very important because when your grass cutters are due for sales, you need to transport them with something. Transport boxes come in handy in these situations. You can either make your transport boxes using wood, or you can make them using iron meshes. You can also, you also need scraper. Scraper is like a packer. These are iron packers. You need them in your farm. These are tools, farm implements that a profitable grasshopper farmer should have. Farm hand. You need a farm hand. If your grasshopper farm exceeds, say, 5-10 colonies, I think you need a farm hand. If your grasshopper farm gets into 20 colonies, you need farm hands. If your grasshopper farm increases to 50 colonies, remember that you need farm hands. You need to employ labor. You need to teach people what to do so that they too can lessen the burden for you and step in for you when you're not available. You need to work with them on a salary basis. Don't employ your family members into your farm just because you need farm hands. No, I beg. You need to get a salary structure in your farm, in the sense that whosoever is working on your farm earns a salary, and that person should be committed to the vision of the farm. Make them part of the vision. You should make your farm hands part of the vision. Okay, so this is for the breeding aspect. These are the things you need for the breeding. You need the breeding knowledge, you need a pen, you need to acquire cages, either you use concrete. Concrete floor cages, concrete wall cages, or concrete iron mesh cages. You need troughs for drinking and for feeding. These troughs can also be used to feed grasshoppers. Use them to feed them your pelletized feed in the afternoon, and also use it to feed them with corn or your cassava tubers or potato tubers. You need a feed source for your profitability to be ensured. You need a feed source. You can always use primary school around you where forage grow, or secondary school around you, or clean roadside that you know that these places are neat as your feed sources. You need to also have market women who you go to get these agro byproducts from. Ogo, watermelon, and the rest from. You need sugarcane sellers too. You need a first aid box. You said you need these farm implements, machetes for cutting your grasses, wheelbarrows, shovel, transport boxes, scraper. We also said you need a farm hand, and you should work with them on a salary basis and ensure you make them part of the vision. Are we still here? Yeah. So before we proceed to the next section, which is the marketing, let's see. Okay. Okay, yeah, welcome Izuoti, good to have you. Good to have you, Emeka Mechanic. I don't know if you guys came late or early. Ifeoma Ritan Zeribe, Antifi, you're welcome. Amadi Chena, Ebeniza, and Tewa Mancho, you guys are highly welcome. So we just finished the section for the things you need in the breeding section to start a profitable grasshopper farming business. Now we go into the marketing section. In the marketing section, the three things you need to start a profitable grasshopper farming business are: one, you need a customer avatar; two, you need a traffic source; three, you need marketing tools. For a customer avatar, is simply a fictitious representation of your ideal customer. You should have in mind who your ideal customer is. Okay, is how do you treat the feeding trough to avoid and prevent cement poisoning? Don't worry, at the end of this class, I'm going to give five to ten minutes for question and answer. So I will attend to your question and answer during the Q&A session. So in the customer avatar section. That's for marketing. This will be the marketing section. A customer avatar is an ideal representation of who your ideal customer is. Listen, guys, if you're getting into any industry, one of the things I learned back when I started my business was to actually define who it is I intend to serve. Who do I want to serve? Who do I want to set, help, teach how to breed, handle, and profitably sell grasshoppers? You should be able to have a clear idea of who this person is. In your mind's eye, who do you want to serve? What is his name? Is his name Emeka? You need to write it down. You need to create a story about this Emeka. What is Emeka's problems? If you are able to create a customer avatar for your grasshopper farming business, what you have simply done is you have simply solved 50% of the challenges every unprofitable grasshopper farming business has. Most unprofitable grasshopper farming business has a problem of defining who it is they want to serve. They do not know who they want to serve. They forgot that even our very own president, His Excellency General Muhammadu Buhari, told us that he belongs to everybody but belongs to nobody. That is how a profitable grasshopper farming businessman should think. You should actually know, define who it is you intend to sell your grasshopper farming products to. What this helps you do is this: if you actually have an idea of who you want to sell your products to, now see one thing with the social media of today. In the social media world of today, if you put out something, a content, so to say, you will see a lot of people who will attack you. But having a clear idea of who you want to serve, what it does is this: when those people attack you for maybe they try to criticize your work, it doesn't even move you one bit, because you know that these are not the people you are targeting. So their opinion does not matter. A popular quote says, those that matter don't mind, and those that mind don't matter. Are you getting the idea? So you should actually have, from before you start a profitable grasshopper farm, you should first of all, in your marketing section, define who it is you want to sell your grasshoppers to. Who do you want to sell your breeding stocks to? Who do you want to sell your table-sized grasshoppers to? Who deserves to have access to your seminars? Who deserves to buy your books? You should be able to sit down and define this person. The moment you define this person, define his pain points, define his problems, you can actually present, make an offer that this person will not refuse. That is it for the customer avatar. Sit down and define who it is you want to serve in the grasshopper farming industry. Before you start your farm, before you purchase that grasshopper you are about to purchase down, simply define who do you want to sell these grasshoppers to when they start producing. It is very important. Secondly, you need a traffic source. A traffic source is a source of is a source where you generate a lot of people who are interested in what that in whatever it is you are selling. Are you selling feeding drinking troughs or feeding troughs? Are you selling your grasshopper seminars? Are you selling your grasshopper video CDs? Are you selling your breeding stock? You should be able to identify a traffic source where you can always go to, see a lot of people, talk to them, and they'll give you a feedback. Traffic sources can include churches. You can see people, most people do their marketing in churches. They go to churches and they give free seminars, and people who are interested, they start fresh a business from there. Traffic source can be your offices, a place where people congregate. You can pitch your idea or your offer to them there. You can get people who are interested in purchasing your grasshopper farming products from them. Your contact list is also a traffic source. A lot of us have this present challenge. We're actually looking for things outside when we actually have them inside. I think that popular Nigerian saying says that is what you define for Sokoto, you there for Shakoto. Most of us have a lot of net, a lot of worthy individuals on our contact. What they simply need is for you to create an offer and make them that offer, and they will not refuse. Your contact list, some of us have up to 300, 500, 1,000, 2,000 people in our contact list. That is a good traffic source. You can start your marketing from your contact list. Social media platforms also come in handy. The Facebook of today, the YouTube of today, the Twitter of today, Instagram of today, these platforms are huge traffic source. Let me tell you a truth. I think 95% of people who have purchased my grasshopper farming products and services have always come from social media. Yes, I concentrate my marketing efforts on social media. I use both paid traffic and organic traffic to grow my business on social media. Why? Because it is the new media of today. Imagine running ads for as low as 500 naira a day. Imagine running ads for as low as 400 naira a day. That's 400 naira, 500 naira you could have used to drink beer or do something. You can easily use it to improve your business, generate more traffic through social media. Search engines. You can also get traffic through search engines. You can get traffic through Google, because people go there to search for information. If you go there to search now, go just start type grasshopper farming. You will see Google auto suggestion will simply pop up and even help you complete the search you are trying to make. These are worthy and credible traffic sources. The third thing you need in your marketing section are marketing tools. You need communication tools, tools that you can use to communicate to your customers affordably. You need email service providers, you need instant messengers, you need any form of, all forms of communication tools, WhatsApp business, box senders, all these things are communication tools that you can use to reach your customers whenever and wherever they are. We also need content creation tools. These are tools that you can simply use to create content, to make videos, cool videos about grasshoppers, cool text about grasshoppers, animations. These are tools you need in your marketing department. You also need CRMs, customer relationship management softwares to help you manage your customer relationships. So in your marketing sections, these are the three things you need to start a profitable, to even start and run a profitable grasshopper farming business. A customer avatar. Calmly sit down and identify who it is you want to serve. When my grasshoppers are ready to be sold, who would I really want to sell it to? What is his name? What is his problem? You need a traffic source where you can go to and search for this person and show them what you have. Because most times our problem is that we are not even in front of our ideal customers. Our problem is that we are not even showing up in front of our ideal customers frequently. You need to be in the presence of your ideal customers as often as you can. because the more you are in his face, the more you influence his or her buying decisions. You need a traffic source, then you need marketing tools to be able to reach out to these audience. So these are the three things you need in your marketing section. Then for the third thing you need, that is transport and the logistics company. You need a transport and a logistic company to be able to handle this particular products and services you are creating. Let's assume somebody buys you 5 kilometers of glass cutters and the person is in Abuja. All you simply need to do, if you don't have an agreement to come with the animals to see the person, you can simply go to Peacemass Transit. Nobody, people did not pay me to make this mention. I'm simply saying because I use them often and on. I simply use Peacemass or locate any other transport company around you that applies that route. Assuming I want to send from Montana, I'll simply go to Peacemass Park or go to, what is this other company? God is good. Any other that agrees to carry, we'll negotiate our price. I make sure that the price I negotiate is affordable for me to be able to make profit, and also for the animals to be able to be comfortable in that vehicle till they get to their destination in Otako. Either they stop at Otako or at Jabi. The moment they stop, the driver will simply call the receiver. Please, your animals are at our park. Come and pick them up. The receiver simply goes there, picks it up, does a 1 minute video or snaps and sends it to confirm that he or she has received his or her products. Simple. Business done clean and nice. Simply locate any of the transport companies plying your route and simply use them to do deliveries. This is the easiest it can be done. Simply make your transport boxes. Locate a carpenter. Tell him to make transport boxes for you. Once somebody pays for your animals, get your transport box, package the animals, put enough food for them in their cages, and supply. So these are the three sections. Breeding section. These are the 8 things you need in the breeding section to start a profitable grass cutter farming business. In the marketing section, these are the 3 things you need: a customer avatar, traffic source, marketing tools. Then for the delivery, which is the last section, you need the transport and the logistic company. So I hope I've been able to do justice to this particular topic for you. So if you have a question you intend to ask, let me give 5 minutes for question and answer. Let me go to the comment section and pick out questions and answer them one after the other. Okay, Izuoti, you said, how do you treat the feeding trough to avoid and prevent cement poisoning? To treat this, the drinking trough, the moment the cement dry up, simply use hot water and enough detergent to wash. Wash well with hot water. Wash and rinse with hot water, then allow to dry. That should take care of this the remnants of the cement. Christopher Amey said, please, what's the name of the app that identify forage again, please? It's called Plant Snap. Just go to Google Play Store and Google Plant Snap. Key in Plant Snap, you should be able to see the app. Download. It's a very fantastic app, so I'm telling you. Just open the app, see any plant, snap. The app will tell you the name of that plant. If it doesn't know the name, it will suggest, make a suggestion for you. I'm telling you, it's awesome. You're going to love it. It was introduced to me by one of our members in Wafan. Fred, your question, you said, I am interested in the movable cage. How many grass cutters can it contain? This is 4-acre cages. 4-acre cages can contain 4 colonies, that is 20 animals. Each deck contains 5 animals, that's 1 colony, 1 male and 4 females. So 4 decks will contain 20 animals, that is each deck containing 5 animals, 5, 10, 15, 20. That's 20 animals. Okay. So if you have a question in the next 2 minutes or so, please type your question in the comment section and I will attend to it. 2 minutes more before we round up. It's 9:58. Once it's 10 o'clock, we round up. We'll be right back. All right, guys, thank you for joining me. It's good to have you all here. Thanks, and thanks for the questions. I hope I did justice to them. See you next week, Thursday, for another edition of our Thursday weekly webinars. Thank you, and good night. Have a wonderful night first. Cheers.